Good Wednesday, everybody. The 2nd of November, 2022. My name is Jewel, and this is the Weather Channel of J7409. Thank you so much for clicking play and checking out all of the weather with me today. Look here, folks. We've got another system to follow, and we're going to have to follow it. Severe weather tomorrow. Tornado chances up to 5%. And what a battle do we have going on with the temperatures. A dramatic contrast in the weather patterns, folks. It's going to occur the rest of this week through the weekend. Now, it's looking like the West will be well below average temperatures. That's going to be your main thing. But also, meanwhile, heavy mountain snow and bouts of heavy rain, they're also going to occur. Meanwhile, east of the Rockies, warm and mild with above average temperatures. And when you get right in between, that severe weather is expected with heavy rain right through the rest of this week for many places. Here's a NAM map courtesy of Tropical Tidbits as I turn it on. You can see the heavy snow that's coming on across. I posted all of those watches and warnings yesterday over on the community page. So you guys, please go check out. I have new stuff up today for everyone. That's of main concern. And if the weather isn't wacky enough, what's going on in this world, folks? I know you've probably heard, but just in case you haven't, North Korea fired at least 23 missiles over at South Korea. And what is that going to cause? One of them got within 65 miles of the border. That's pretty doggone close. Then we have Afghanistan. We have Iran, Saudi Arabia, especially Saudi Arabia and Iran. They're going at it. Of course, we got Russia and Ukraine, and we got China and Taiwan that looks like it's going to light up like a Christmas tree before long. So, folks, please pray about all of this. And now, let's get on with the weather. We're going to check everything out, folks, and I'm going to have all that tropical stuff for you, too. So please stick around and pay attention to it, because it looks like we'll have to wait and see what happens. Of course, remember, things can change, but it could affect the Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, and North Carolina coastlines. We'll just have to wait and see. But first, the severe weather, getting on with it for tomorrow. Today, nothing to worry about. Tomorrow, we do have this chance of severe weather from portions of Nebraska, Kansas, Oklahoma, and Texas. And that tornado percentage-wise went up just like I told you it was, especially in Kansas, Oklahoma, and Texas panhandles here right in this area. And it's going to move on across. Now, what's it going to bring? High wind gust, hail, and tornadoes are expected. Now, the chance of the wind, it's going to pick up in the very same areas, and that chance of hail goes from Texas all the way to Nebraska at a 5% chance. Another quick look at the temperatures. My goodness, what a drastic contrast and change. I'm just telling you what, folks, the West is freezing. This is highs for today. Highs for today. Look at Idaho. 43, 41. You move up in Montana, you're in the 30s. Oh my goodness, look here in Wyoming, 28 for a high. Cold, cold, cold. Not to say, I haven't forgot all my friends in Canada. You guys got it bad too. Please stay warm. When you move on across to the east side, well, we got warmer temperatures over here. Florida in the 80s, Texas in the high 70s and 80s, Oklahoma in 72s right here, lower 70s. That's all going to change for you guys as this moves on down. So please be aware of what's going on. Keep up. Once again, check out the community page for weather that you need to know about. Lots of snow, folks, for a lot of people. Now, I've got this set for just who's going to get at least 1 inch? Just about everybody you see over here. You can see the percentages you have right here. The darker the colors, the higher the chance. This is 1 inch of snow. We'll check out 2 inches of snow, Well, let it come up here right quick. You can see the snow is going to continue. This is within a 24-hour period. Today, this time, until tomorrow, okay? This is the snow that is going to be happening, and it will increase. As you can see, we've got 4 inches now. 4 inches, up to 50% chance here in Nevada, around the San Francisco area, moving right on along where you see this dark blue. And when it starts to turn orange, that's 80% chance. This is at least 4 inches of snow, folks, within 24 hours today. We'll bump it on up to around 6 inches. You can see, still, we have very good chance of around 30%, some of that happening in Utah and Montana. And what about 8 inches? We'll see. Some people have even got more than 8 inches. But within 24 hours now, I'm not talking about the snow you got yesterday. That would make it even more. You do have a chance of some 8 inches falling up in Montana around these areas. And it could happen in Wyoming, but I doubt it's only like a 5 or 10% chance. But the snow is going to be coming down within the next 24 hours for many, many, many of you. So be aware, stay safe. You can see everybody in these areas are going to see some snow. Now let's check out the tropics. Here we have Hurricane Lisa. Right now the winds are 75 miles per hour. It is a Category 1. The pressure is 988 millibars. It's located 17.2 north, 86.7 west. It's moving west at 15 miles per hour. The watches and warnings are over on the community page. We will check it out, though, and everybody, especially down around Belize, be prepared. Looks like it's coming right in your way. Then we have Martin. It's a tropical storm. The winds are 65 miles per hour. The pressure is 989 millibars. Now, it's building strength, but it's going to get pushed on out, folks. It's located at 35.3 north, 52.1 west. It's moving east-northeast around 15 miles per hour. We've got a big low up here. It's going to kind of pull it on up and mix it in. But this is something we've all got to pay attention to. Now, it's just a complex broad area, low pressure, but it is expected to develop this weekend near the Greater Antilles or over the southwestern Atlantic. Now, some slow tropical, subtropical, or tropical development of this system is possible after it moves generally northward to the north-northwestward areas. Like, once it gets up past Dominican Republic and Puerto Rico, right up in this area, it could start generating some things. So let's go check a few things out. On the watches and warnings map from the National Hurricane Center, this is Hurricane Lisa. As you can see, she was right here earlier today and turning into a hurricane. She is a hurricane now. And this red, all of this red and these little islands off of Honduras here, this is a hurricane warning. Right smack dab in the middle of the area of Belize, right in here, say Belize City, moving right on up as you can see on the coastline of Mexico here. Now, it should travel on along. Once it hits land, it should start to disintegrate and then just be a tropical storm, then a tropical depression, lose a little strength, and then it looks like it's going to get back in the Gulf and be a depression again by this weekend. I'll keep my eyes on that also and see what happens with it. But if you're in this area here, please get ready. You know you should have already been ready. It's only going to be a matter of hours before it hits land. Okay, let's check out the Euro, the GFS, and the Icon, see what's going on. This is the Euro model. I have it set for 4 p.m. this afternoon. You can see Lisa is looking like it's starting to begin to get really close to coming inland around Belize here. So please stay safe. Up here's Martin. I told you, that big old system right up in here, Martin's going to get pulled on up and pulled on and not bother anybody. Martin's a much stronger storm than Lisa is right now. But that next system that is going to happen, man, oh man, I hope it doesn't happen. And this is what's left of Lisa over here. Remember how we got in the Gulf? Winds in it aren't hardly power. That's what it's looking like now. and you have this tropical wave that's going to come across up here. Let's turn on the pressure gradient right quick for one moment. I'm on here. You can see we got a big high up here. Well, that's pushing this little system down, okay? Pushing it down. Barometric pressure, 29.74. This is around Sunday, around 2 p.m. Barometric pressure is not that really bad right now. Not bad at all, but we'll continue to move along to say, that was Saturday. This is Sunday, this coming Sunday. The barometric pressure, 29.75. Now, this is on the euro. It looks like it's going to get sucked up and become a big low pressure system. But is that what's going to stay? I doubt it. We'll move on up. Let's get to, say, Monday around 7 p.m. You can see it splits up. We got one here. We got one here. And they're moving towards the Bahamas. Now, this is just from the systems that's moved off with the high pressure pushing down this wind that you see here. Has nothing to do with these pressures here, okay? The Gulf's still looking good, but it is across Florida as the system keeps getting pushed down. The wind is going to be on the East Coast. I mean, it's not going to be storm, but you're going to feel it 33 miles per hour. You're going to see it gusting up. Now, you see how it's moving over. These are moving over. Now, this is on the Euro model. Let's check over to the icon right quick. And this only goes out to Sunday around 8 p.m. It's got a high pressure down here. See how these models change? Can't go by one, but the system still looks like it's up here. With that high still pushing it down, so it can't really go anywhere spectacular at all. You got a high here pushing, you got a high here pushing, and it's kind of stuck right around here. That's the icon. We'll go back to the Euro for the same time on Sunday, say around 8 p.m. And at this particular time on the Euro, it looks like those two lows kind of merged together. But right here, if you look closely, this is trying to get a little bit of circulation. And it's a little bit farther east than over on the icon model. What does the GFS say? We'll check it out right quick. And the GFS has it just about in the same area. So all three are pretty much in the ballpark of where the highest winds are going to be. This is Sunday, 49 mile per hour winds, okay? This is what it's looking like. But I do want to go back over to the Euro model. And I want to stretch this out. So let's go move up. I'm not going to go any further than this, but this will be next Tuesday. You can see why I'm saying now it's changing. As you can see up here, this is low pressure, low pressure. It's beginning to pull it up. We still have some high pressure pushing it down, though. And you can see that it is pointing over this way. Okay, so I'm not saying we're going to get anything. I'm not saying it's going to make up into anything. I'm saying it could very possibly could. Okay, so North Carolina, South Carolina, Virginia, and Florida on the eastern side of Florida, the coastlines here, everybody needs to pay attention and stay up to date on this new system that has popped up. Like I told you the other day, it would not surprise me at all if we didn't have one, two, or three more systems pop up in November, and it looks like they are popping up. So please, please keep up and be aware. Have yourself a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day, my friends. I love each and every one of you. Yes, I do, and I thank you. I am so grateful to Jesus and to you, my YouTube family and friends. You keep me smiling. You keep my mindset straight. I don't get depressed over things, but I do try to warn you of things. And look, really, we all need to pray about what's going on in the world right now, because it ain't pretty. So please pray everything calms down. Everyone is safe. Jesus tells us there's going to be wars and rumors of wars. Jesus tells us there's going to be plagues. Jesus told us all this stuff was coming. Pray for salvation and pray for safety, my friends. Hey, don't forget to subscribe. Click the J7409 Weather Ensemble in the bottom right-hand corner. Click that bell and check off all to get all my latest weather videos. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.